Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to read our chapter 4 of Moral Science, Looking London, Talking Tokyo, A Tale of Tree Told by a Tree. Long ago, in the days of ancestors, there was a warrior named Talking Forest. All the people treated Talking Forest as one of their own relatives. Talking Forest also loved his people. His people loved to give gifts to each other, and because Talking Forest had so many friends, he owned many, many things. There was a magical mediator in the village. He had a talking stick, which enabled the things to talk. One day, a mediator of the people approached Talking Forest and said, "Talking Forest, I have overheard some young warriors talking about you. They were saying, what they were saying is not good. They said you are not a warrior, and the only reason you own so much things is because all the people give you plenty of things." Talking Forest seemed very concerned. He said, "I know these young warriors. They are brave and hardworking. But why would they say such things about me?" To this, the mediator replied, "When these warriors were younger, their fathers were killed defending their villages. Since the fathers were not there to teach their sons the way to honor someone or something." The mediator asked, "Talking Forest, the things that you own, how important are they to you?" Talking Forest said, "Nothing is more important to me than the love I have for my people, and everything that I own reminds me of the love they bestowed over me." The mediator went to the sarpanch and asked him to call a meeting of the people. The sarpanch knew the best way to gather his people. When the sarpanch had gathered his people together, he said, "Our mediator has something important to say." The mediator told of his overhearing the young brave talking about Talking Forest and called them forward in front of the people. The young warriors felt ashamed. The mediator asked all the people to be quiet because Talking Forest had something to say to these young warriors. The mediator handed Talking Forest the talking stick. Talking Forest started, "When I was young, our people suffered many seasons since a great spirit cursed us with a very little of water. And because of that drought-like situations, the wolves used to attack our village. During those bad times, my father and I were protecting a group of children gathering water when we were attacked by wolves. My father was killed. I led the children safely back to the village. Because of it, I was given a place among the people to always protect the children. When the other warriors went out to battle or hunt, I do not ride with them. I stay in the village and protect it from the attack while our warriors are gone. As Talking Forest continued, all eyes of the elders went on him. You young warriors think everything I own is important for me. They shook their heads in yes. He told them, I can give away everything that I own, and I give it all to you to divide up between you. However, the one thing I cannot give you is the love that was bestowed upon me. A quick little child grabbed the talking stick from Talking Forest's hand, and the little boy told of the gift he gave to Talking Forest for helping him. He did not want Talking Forest to give it away. Many people took the talking stick and told stories of why they had given Talking Forest a gift. Now the mediator asked Talking Forest, did you receive any gifts from these young warriors' fathers? And do you remember which gift they gave you? Talking Forest answered, of course, I grew up with all of their fathers, and even though they are no longer with us, I remembered them through the gifts they gave me. The main gift was living along them. I always had their trustworthiness. I worked like a babysitter. The mediator turned to the young warriors and asked, all the things that belong to Talking Forest now belong to you. What will you do with them? Not one word was spoken among the people while the young warriors were going to the forest to talk about what to do. When they returned from the forest, the oldest took the talking stick and began, we do not want those things that belong to Talking Forest, but we want to know about our fathers and their stories that Talking Forest could tell us. The elders knew the young warriors were being tested by the mediator, and that the warriors were turning out a prudent young man. And so it was agreed by all the people that each warrior would keep the things intact with the Talking Forest, and in lieu he would tell them the stories of them. The young warriors returned all the gifts that Talking Forest had received from their forefathers. Now the young warriors knew that Talking Forest was truly a great warrior for their people, a very humble warrior. So the moral of the story is, humility tells us that no human being is perfect. Thus, strive to improve. Only the trees teach us to stay still. Bend always if we want to bear the fruits of fulfillment. Thank you and have a nice day.